Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you're new here. If you haven't been here before, I'm Jamie and I am a makeup addict and I'm not stopping anytime soon. I'm trying to slow myself down a little bit, but like the holidays are coming and these new holiday releases are out there and it's like so tempting. There's discounts everywhere and coupons, all kinds of crap. And I'm like, I gotta buy it. So I'm a makeup addict. And I'm here to share the information with you guys, making it somewhat valuable for me to buy all this makeup. I might as well talk to somebody about it so someone else might be getting some type of benefit from all of my crazy purchases. So Laura Geller was having a 50% off sale. I think that they emailed me about it, or I might be on their marketing list, their text list or whatever. But I was notified about 50% off, and you know, 25% off is appealing, but 50% off, now I can get down with that. So I went on there and I picked up an eyeshadow palette and five different lipsticks, lip gloss, lip formulas that I wanted to talk to you guys about and really talk to you about the reason I love Laura Geller and why I would be interested in this to even start out with. So Laura Geller, a while ago, I got this like Best of QVC kit that my mom got me for Christmas because she loves QVC and blah, blah, blah. So she picked this kit up for me, and this was like years ago now. And there was this Laura Geller lipstick in there, and I still have it. And it was in the color Fresh Brew. And I don't know what kind of formula this was or what it was. I had never really tested that many Laura Geller products in the past. Anyway, I found this lipstick and it's really creamy and hydrating and like the perfect color. And I'm like, let me check out some more Laura Geller. So I've seen them on and off at TJ Maxx over the years, and there's all kinds of different palettes and stuff that come there. I've always heard that their eyeshadow palettes did not have that great of reviews. I was watching Lipstick Leslie, I think it is, the other day, and she was talking about some Laura Geller products, and I was like, maybe I'm gonna give their eyeshadows a try because I had just heard some mixed reviews. It sounded like maybe there were some good things about their baked eyeshadow palettes. So I own blushes from Laura Geller. I think I own a bronzer from Laura Geller, some face foundation, like the mineral foundation, and I own this lipstick, which I love. So this like stemmed a bunch of the purchases, and then I decided I was gonna try a eyeshadow palette. So this is one of their new palettes. It's called the Delectables, and it's a baked eyeshadow palette, and it is in Midnight Munchies is the name of it. So cute. But the colors on this, I thought, were awesome. They are $120 retail for this, but I got it for 10 bucks, right? Because of that sale. So I like could not resist. It looks really pretty. And you know, the problem, I'll tell you all about the problems I have with this, but I have it on my eyes right now. I put it on. I've worn it 3 times now, and I'm filmed this eye look, and I'm gonna insert that at the end of the video. No sound, just kind of speed through the eye look so you can see how these went on. But like no problems with the shadows. But let me tell you like about the formula, and like we'll step through it, and then I'll save the lip products for last and go over that. So this is gonna be $20 on their website. I haven't seen it anywhere else. I haven't ever looked anywhere else. The 50% off coupon, I don't know. Sign up for their emails. Like if you go to their website, then all of a sudden Facebook's gonna start marketing to you, you know, and Instagram will start marketing to you. And I think that's how I got it somehow, in that weird, weird spying on my sites type of way. So anyway, it worked out for me because I got all the stuff for like 50 bucks. So anyway, let's go through this. So here is the eyeshadow palette swatched. So there is a shade right here, but you can barely see it. And I'll go through these, but you can see right away, like the darkest color was this one right here. Or really, I don't know, this one's kind of the darkest color, but pretty good range of like neutral everyday shades. Love this type of color story. I think that these are really, really pretty. They swatch pretty well, but there's some tricks with this palette. And part of the reason it's tricky is because these pans are so far in there and it's hard for you to like get a brush in there, for me anyway. So I'm gonna experiment on trying to take this outer packaging or something off to try to get to those pans, because I really feel like that is the biggest problem. Is like, I mean, these do have a pretty good amount of fallout because they are baked formulas, but like working your way in there is like 90% of the problem for me. But they are really, really pretty, and I think so far I like it. Now, I think this is interesting because this is kind of like, you know, my mom's brand of makeup, kind of QVC type style. But they're really pretty shadows. And one thing I noticed is that because the mattes are so like light, I feel like, and powdery, they won't stay on your eyes. I wear an eyeshadow primer, and I don't know how many older people wear eyeshadow primers. I guess that's just one thing I was thinking when I was putting it on. I was like, oh, it's pretty, but like my mom doesn't wear an eyeshadow primer. She would have no idea how to use this palette. So anyway, that's just a thought that came through my head, but let's go through this. Beautiful colors. I can tell you about them really quick. They're all baked shadows. This one is this light frosted donut color. There is a swatch right here. I don't know if you can see it. It's like my skin tone. And this one was the most difficult to swatch by far. I don't understand why, but it definitely is. When you do this too, when you finger swatch, you're going to get a lot of powderiness out of there. But I did use this as like an all over eye setting color and it worked pretty well. So I didn't have any problems. They're buildable. They're definitely extremely soft, but buildable, very user friendly, so on and so forth. So there's a vanilla pudding shade there. This is Hot Churro. It is a baked metallic apple crumble, baked metallic. You can see, you know, this is a nice light color. This is more of like a little bit more of a caramely beige color, you know, really, really pretty. And then this is Caramel Cluster, which is a matte. And then we have Chocolate Soufflé, which is one of the darkest of those shades, those metallic shades. Weird that there's one right here and one right here, and they're both like pretty similar in color. Like maybe this chocolate souffle is like a little bit like greener toned, you can see. Anyway, moving into these mattes, there's Butter Toffee, which is super pretty, Banana Split, which is next to that one, and then we move into Cherry Pie, this pretty cherry metallic color, or like, you know, rosy color, so pretty. Then Fortune Cookie, a little bit of a mid-tone brown there. Pecan Bar, which is the darkest shade, and then Coffee Cake, which is the darkest matte shade. So really, really pretty selection here. I think another problem I have with this is like, I can't really tell what color is darker than the next one. Like, I had trouble seeing like, is this one darker than this one? Or is this one darker than this one? Like, because of the way that they're positioned in this and because of the darkness that comes when you have this down on your counter and you're using it, you cannot really see these shadows very well. So they're a little powdery, can't see them very well. They're hard to get your brush into, but they are very, very beautiful if you can get over some of those little obstacles. So pretty, pretty, $20. I think it's really cute. I would wait for a sale or try to find a sale, but for 10 bucks, yes. And look, I think it's really pretty. So, and I've worn them for like 3 days and had no problem with them sticking around. Like I said, though, I do wear an eyeshadow primer. All right, moving on to the lips. So let me take this off my lips. I've got a different lipstick on right now. I'm gonna take it off and we are gonna get to swatching. All right, my lips are naked and we're getting into the fun part. All right, so I got a couple different types because there are all different types. There is Italian Marble, which was, you know, I was looking and it seemed like they would be a good blend. Now they had some available, like some lipsticks that look like really weird and pointy and swooped and had some really designs embossed into them. And they had those at TJ Maxx a while ago, and they were not good at all. Not good at all. So I was like, oh no, Laura Geller might not be as good for lip products as I thought that they would be. But then when I went on their website, I see there is a lot going on there. And then some of these were really on sale, and I got one of them for free, a gift with purchase, this Amarina. This is the Italian marble Amarina color. So I'll try that one on too. That one was a free gift with purchase. So I bought this berry banana in Italian marble. And then I bought Figure Than Life in this jelly balm, because I wanted to try that. And then I bought a modern lipstick. I bought Elite in that one. And then I bought their tinted lip oil in Runner Up. So it was a little bit confusing on the site, like trying to figure out the colors too. I just wasn't sure what I was getting. I was not happy with the colors, and I could not find a lot of people trying them on. So here I am. So let's go with Figure Than Life. First, this is like one of their newer formulas, I think. Hydrating lip color, it's called. It's a jelly balm. And they're all around the $20 price tag. And anyway, it's like this pretty silver packaging. It's plastic. It's definitely not metal. And it's just like a twist up at the bottom. And then there is the color right there. This is Figure Than Life. I was thinking this was going to be a little bit less pigmented, but I'll show you. I'll put it on. So I guess number one, they didn't have any I like nudes, period. They didn't really have anything like that. So this was the closest thing I thought that I could get to something I would wear. This feels hydrating. It feels like a lipstick. It doesn't really feel like a lip balm. I definitely feel like a lipstick. And because it is so pigmented, it just reminds me of a lipstick. Like, I would think a balm would be less pigmented, but that's just my thought. I think it looks pretty. It's moisturizing, feels good on the lips. It has like a kind of a creamy finish, definitely not matte, not the shiniest of finishes, but you can see it's a nice finish. It's definitely gonna move if you eat, if I kiss somebody, if I do something. It's just gonna wear off, but I mean, it's a sweet color. It's just definitely not my typical color. I don't really go pinky all that often, so. You know, kind of a regret. I just wish it was a different color, but I do like the formula, and I need to branch out and do things, you know, like maybe this is God telling me just wear some pink or something. Anyway, so this is the first color. Let me know what you guys think about it, but feels like a really good formula. It just feels really, you know, hydrating. I'm trying to look. It says it's like a jelly color, you know, and they call it a jelly balm. But I don't feel like it's that jelly. It's just not really what I'm getting out of it. Hydrating, yes. Jelly, I wouldn't say so. All right, let's take this one off and try on the next one. All right, and then by the way, just so you know, I typically like lean towards the really glossy lips. That's just kind of what my style is. And I don't know why I keep buying lipsticks, because lip gloss is typically what I like anyway. So I don't know what's wrong with me, but I like makeup, so I just buy a bunch of crap. All right, so tinted lip oil in Runner Up. This one was on sale, and then it was 50% off. So bargain there. So here it is. Here is the packaging. Looks nice. Let's see the doe foot. It's just a nice little small doe foot. All right, and this one feels really good. I don't know why it was on sale. I have no idea. It's a really pretty color. I hope I don't get it on my teeth. Feels moisturizing, feels thin, not sticky at all. I mean, this is really pretty. I wore this for a while yesterday. These are kind of first impressions because I haven't worn these too long. I just got them 2 days ago, so I just worn them a couple times, but it does feel really good on the lips, and It didn't have any problems like wearing away really quickly or doing anything like that. It's just a lip oil. It feels good. Yes, definitely approve. I would buy this one. I would recommend. So we're swatching away here though. Let's get on to the next one. All right, now we'll go with the freebie. So I've got, this one came in the Italian marble formula, and then I bought berry banana in the Italian marble formula. I did not realize that these were very sheer. So I had thought that like this one would be really sheer. The jelly balm, that one's not so sheer, but these are really sheer. And then I have Amarina is the color here. Actually, let me swatch these for you guys just so you see. Here is Amarina, so pretty. This one looks pretty. It is cool toned. I don't wear that many cool tones, but this one was tricky too because they didn't have like an example of this one and I couldn't find it anywhere and it was free, so I didn't know what I was gonna get, but really pretty, really pretty. Just like total nude. I don't even think it leans very cool. It's very neutral. This is a win for sure for me. Let me also swatch the other ones just so you see them on my hand. That might be helpful. So Figure Than Life, which was that jelly balm that we did earlier. That one is much more cool toned. That's that one. This is the one I have on right now. And then I will swatch the lip gloss. All right, there was that lip gloss right there in runner up, jelly balm in Figure Than Life, and then Italian lip color in Amarina. I don't think they sell this regularly. They might, actually they might. But if you want it, it was a free gift with purchase. So, and then let's take this one off. Let's go for the next one. So this one is Berry Banana. This one's super sheer. A little bit of a cooler tone, just super neutral, really sheer, very easy to wear. Berry Banana. Just really moisturizing, feels very good on the lips. You can see it's got a little bit of a gloss to it, not fussy at all. I like this. I could definitely get down with this. I would really recommend these Italian marble ones. All right, let's take this one off. Last one. So honestly, this one like pissed me off as soon as I opened the box and I saw how brown it was. I was like, damn it. That is not what I wanted. That is not the color that I thought it would be. But this is in the Modern Classic lipstick, and this is the color Elite. Looks very brown on the outside, but wait, let's see. Here it is, swatch. And you can see it's not that brown. It's really, really pretty. So there it is. This is Elite, and this is my favorite for sure. They all feel really good, so I can't say like this is the best formula out of all of them. I think the only one that I'm not really excited about so much is that jelly balm one. I just didn't really love the formula. It wasn't what I thought it was gonna be. I thought it'd be more shiny. So I'm not a huge jelly balm fan, but the rest of them I really like. I really like the formula on the other ones. And perhaps if I liked this color, I would like it more, but I don't know. I mean, I think that these other ones, this Modern Classic and the Italian Marble, are really, really great formulas. I would definitely recommend them. They feel fantastic on the lips. And then the Treat and Go, this tinted lip oil, yes, this is really great. So I hope this was valuable to you. I definitely found out something I didn't know. I really like the Laura Geller products, and their lip products are where it's at. So check that out. And who doesn't want this, really? It's beautiful. I just had to figure out the packaging. So, all right. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you guys later. Bye.